Have you ever heard of WHTV? Producing, recording, being on TV.
Look at the time, Wiley.
Wow, we should really get going.
Yep. Merry Crimbus, Winnicunnet.
And happy holidays. Welcome back to another Merry episode with your favorites.
So what did you get Nick for Christmas, Wiley?
I haven't gotten him anything yet. I still have a while.
Well, Josie and Julia just did a story on what to get your significant others for Christmas.
Wait, what? You did this story?
No. Other Julia.
Oh, okay. Well, let's hope I get some ideas.
With the holiday season right around the corner, you're probably scrambling to find the perfect Christmas gift for your significant other.
If you're a lot like Julie and I, you probably don't have racks to drop. So lucky for you, we came up with some of the best and cheap ideas for your homies.
Oh, all right, so like a sweatshirt, or like, for a guy, like a or a girl, just like a sweatshirt. Okay. A nice sweatshirt.
Yeah. You could get them some candies.
I'm going to get Chessie a teddy bear for Christmas.
I'd say that a good cheap gift for your significant other could be a pin to put on like your coat.
You got to go to Salvation Army with $3 and find the best three things that you can. Preferably, I don't know, maybe like a shirt or something.
The 2019 Ford F-150 XL Super Cab 4x4 STX 2.7 liter V6 EcoBoost. $195 a month for 24 months, $3,775 cash due at signing.
You could make them a nice card.
If you're trying to buy a Christmas gift with little money, you should buy candy. So simple, yet so satisfying.
A cute like couple of things together. Like you get like candy, like their favorite candy, some socks, a water bottle.
Pencil caps and pencil grips are pretty cheap.
Nike Elites.
A vinyl for a record player.
Like a sweatshirt or something.
It's always greatly appreciated when your boo pays for your meal. A nice dinner for two at Loss or the Galley Hatch if you're feeling savage is always a kind gesture.
Next on our list for her is jewelry. Now, if you're a guy, you might want to get some help from her friends for this one, but cute earrings and necklaces are always a move, especially if it's from Cinnamon Rainbows or Claire's.
On the pricier side of our list could be a Hydro Flask. You can buy these at Cinnamon Rainbows, Dick's Sporting Goods, or online. To go along with this, you can collect some cute stickers for them to decorate the Hydro with to become a Visco girl.
Who doesn't love a good sweatshirt to hang around in? Buy him or her their favorite brand sweatshirt, Nike, Vans, Carhartt, Summer Sessions, and more. Make sure to buy oversized for cool girl vibes.
There are some pretty cheap phone cases on the market that anyone would love. Check out Marshalls and Target for some cool ones.
Lastly, everyone always appreciates a nice gift card. It could be to their favorite store or a restaurant like KB's or Aromas.
We hope that you thought these ideas were helpful. Even if you're not in a relationship, your friends would still appreciate awesome gifts like these. Happy holidays, Winnicunnet, Josie and Julia signing out.
Wait, should I have said Merry Christmas with you? Or
not
Happy Holidays?
Okay, so that was sort of helpful, but I still don't know what to get him.
Well, you still have 2 weeks left anyway.
Wow, we still have 2 weeks left?
Yep, and yet this is our last episode of the year.
Oh yeah, the faculty show is next week, so this is it till January.
Wow, 2019 has really felt like forever, but it also went by so fast.
I don't even remember half the stuff that happened this year.
Well, that's perfect, because me and Maggie just put together a recap for a bunch of stuff that happened during 2019.
With 2019 quickly coming to a close, it's hard to grasp all that happened in the last year. There were multiple technological advances, scientific discoveries, music performances, and sports events. Let's see how well the students remember some events from 2019.
The Patriots, 13-3. Wait, was it 13-3?
I'm not a Pats fan.
Well, clearly it would have been the Eagles. The Eagles won the Super Bowl of 2019. Because the Patriots, they weren't in it, were they? No, okay. But they didn't win it. Okay.
The Patriots, right? Yeah, the Patriots.
New England Patriots, coached by the GOAT, Bill Belichick, with his side GOAT, Tom Brady.
Wayne's down! They did it! It's over! The game is over! The series is over! The wait is over! And the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions for the first time in franchise history!
The Blues.
Wasn't it Ovechkin? Yeah, Caps. That's what I was trying to think of hockey.
The Capitals, and they're not that good. Only TJ Oshie's good. He's the only one that's good. Oh, the Blues won, and they used to have TJ Oshie, but now he's on the Caps because the Caps are better now.
Now to a developing story in Hollywood. A Disney Channel star has died.
Cameron Boyce, that one just kind of made me feel weird because I grew up watching Jesse, and then he died, and I was like, he's, what, 2 years older than I am? I mean, like, Juice WRLD just died. I mean, rest in peace, I'm sorry, but I'm not a fan of his music, so it didn't hit me as hard as it would have.
Juice WRLD.
Alan Rickman, but Snape will always live on in our hearts. Always. Come again? Cameron Boyce? Don't know him.
What about Juice WRLD?
Don't know him either.
Cameron Boyce.
The Time Person of the Year is 16-year-old climate change activist Greta Thunberg.
Besides Leonardo DiCaprio, Greta Thunberg.
Greta Thunberg.
Oh, Greta Thunberg.
That old guy with like the brown hair. It's like 40. He's not old. Oh, that's you. Yeah. That's what you're talking about. Yeah.
In addition to 2019 coming to a close, it also brings an end to the decade. Many of us have grown and changed over the past 10 years, and the world around us has certainly changed. Let's see what events you probably forgot about in this decade. In April of 2010, the first iPad came out. In April of 2011, William and Kate had a royal wedding. In July 2012, Gangnam Style became the most watched video ever. In February 2013, the Harlem Shake went viral. In July of 2014, everyone started doing the Ice Bucket Challenge. In February of 2015, the internet had a heated debate about a dress. In July of 2016, Pokemon Go became a new sensation. In May of 2017, everyone started playing with fidget spinners. In October 2018, a Banksy painting was self-destructed, and in April of 2019, the first picture of a black hole was taken. Overall, this past decade has been nothing but eventful, so let's see what 2020 has in store. For WHTV, this is Maggie and Julia.
Wow, a lot of stuff happened this year that I completely forgot about.
Yeah, but hopefully next year, people start to care more about our planet.
At least the Sustainability Club has done a lot for the community this year, and with the holiday season coming up, they are getting in the Christmas spirit. This year, the Sustainability Club has continued the tradition to wrap gifts using wrapping paper and gift bags created from reusing paper groceries and shopping bags. This week, they set up a Santa workshop in the library and hand-decorated recycled wrapping materials to make them more festive for the holiday. The club wrapped gifts last Tuesday and Thursday and will continue on Tuesday of next week, after school in the library until 3:30. The public is welcome to come and get their stuff wrapped too.
I literally can't wrap a gift for my life.
Yeah, I know, Julia. Do you remember how you wrapped mine last year? I couldn't tell if that was trash or a present.
Wow, thanks. Those are what all my wrapped gifts look like under the tree on Christmas morning.
Ooh, speaking of Christmas trees, where'd you get yours?
Wow, smooth transition, Wiley. Right into your story. But I got mine somewhere random in Mass.
Well, there's some pretty good places around here to go.
Let's just get to the story.
The Christmas tree tradition started in the 16th century in Germany when Christians started bringing home decorated trees to their families. Christmas trees started in America in 1830 and became popular in the 1890s when ornaments and decorations started being shipped over from Germany. Christmas trees particularly hold a special meaning because they remain green all year long. We asked the students of Winnicunnet what they do for the Christmas tree tradition.
My family's never owned a fake one because fake ones are boring, and it's fun to go find one and like decorate it and stuff every year. So yeah, don't buy fake ones.
All right, so usually we get our Christmas tree like right after Thanksgiving. So that's what we did. So we got it, we put it up, we put all the ornaments on it, all these very like nice ornaments. Some of them were like glass. And then yesterday I came home and the tree had fallen over and glass was just everywhere. It was terrible, absolutely awful. And so now we, my mom isn't home, so we just put the tree outside and we're gonna figure it out, so.
I usually get a real tree, but this year I don't have a tree because I'm going away for Christmas. So we have a little small fake one this year.
First of all, Kylie, fake ones are so much better because you can just get some Christmas tree spray and spray it on your tree and there you go. It smells like a real Christmas tree. They're so much easier.
Christmas tree spray is boring and you should get a real one.
My dilemma is I love real Christmas trees because they smell really good and they're just more Christmassy, but my parents think it makes too big of a mess, so they get a fake one at like Target. And it's not really a tradition anymore because no one decorates the Christmas tree. I don't know why.
Every year I get a real tree. I refuse to get a fake tree because real trees are just better. You get the smell and everything. But next year we're getting a fake one because college. But this year we got our last real tree and it fell over and all the water poured all over our new carpet.
Buying real trees are a huge deal for some families, but some people prefer artificial ones. Artificial trees first started in the 1960s when silver aluminum pine trees became popular. Some now even light up in different colors and they use Christmas tree spray to make it seem like the real thing. We hope that real trees always stay a Christmas tradition though. From WHGB, this is Hannah and Wiley.
That was a pretty good story with some great tips if I do say so myself.
Wow, Wiley. Well, anyway, did you see the Christmas tree in the center of Hampton?
Yeah, I saw it while I was watching the Christmas parade on Saturday.
I didn't get to go, but I heard it was really good this year. This past Saturday, Winnicunnet was well represented in the Hampton Christmas Parade, as chamber singers performed in the center of town, and the Winnicunnet Band, Student Council, and MCJORTC groups all marched in the parade. In addition, the chamber singers and jazz band extended their holiday spirit as they performed at the community event on Monday night. Singing and playing holiday tunes, there was a packed house to watch them perform.
You really missed out, Julia.
Well, I had a really busy weekend. I just can't wait for the holiday break, but I'm sad we don't have another episode because of the faculty show next Friday. But you should all really go make sure to go buy your tickets at the school store or in the library. All the money raised goes to the Nurses Fund to help students right here at our school.
The faculty show is always funny to watch. But speaking of break, that's all we have for you today, Winnicunnet. See you next year.
Really, Wiley?
Too soon? But it's my favorite joke, Julia.
Yeah, too soon. Anyway, see you later, Winnicunnet.